Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy with another in the series. I'm just going to be shaving a cylinder, and I've got the camera on a tripod. I'm using a webcam, so I just basically want to do a quick video to see what this would look like. Don't know how good the resolution is going to be. But this is my shaver. This is an original dictaphone shaver, and made by Columbia. It's very, very simple, straightforward, minimum of moving parts. It does a great job. And what I've done is I've inlet this into a computer desk. This is just a little single, like, student computer desk. It's made of fiberboard and some plastic tubing. It's pretty simple. $5 at a thrift store. So I took a saw, just cut a square in the center, dropped the machine into it. The machine is now wired to a light dimmer from Home Depot. This is just a standard light dimmer. And so that's now the speed control. And it has a chute where the shavings go straight down the center. And under the machine, I have an old trash can. And it gets full surprisingly quickly. It's really surprising how much swarf it generates simply shaving a cylinder. But I'm gonna shave a black wax cylinder. So I just wanted to do a quick video of the process. I'm sure lots of you have seen this before, some of you haven't, but this is the only true effective way to be able to make recordings on the Edison cylinder phonograph. You virtually have to have a shaver. Without a shaver, you're really, really limited in what you're able to do because you simply don't have a blank. And then once you have a standard blank, you can shave it sometimes as many as 15, 16 times. Taking nice smooth cuts and shaving it just enough to remove the old recording. And so it has an end gate just like a phonograph, and it has a movable carriage. It has a cutter. The original is sapphire. This one is made of steel. So we slide on a black wax cylinder. I've already got my depth basically set. So we'll start the shaver. As you can see, the dimmer acts as a speed control. And it's quite effective. But in this case, I'm running it wide open, just going to do a quick shave. I have an old brush here to keep the stylus nice and clean. And just adjust it. And it's shaving the cylinder. So I'm going to shave this one in probably two passes. Stop the shaver, and then since I have this light mounted above it, I just slowly turn the cylinder, and you can see if there's any artifact left over from your last recording. They'll show up as almost like little pits. I mean, this is a vertical format, and so you'll actually see what appear to be little round dots, and those are artifact bits, ghosts of the last recording, which means you haven't shaved it quite deep enough, and there's a few right here. So one more pass. Remember, I shave these the minimum possible, just enough to take off the recording and no more. So another light pass across the cylinder. And the cylinder is now blank and ready to record. So just a real quick video. As I said, I'm using the webcam on a tripod. Really raised it up, so just want to see what kind of shot I can get. But just wanted to do a quick video on the shaver. As always, if you have any questions or comments about recording on the Edison cylinder phonograph or anything I've covered in my YouTube series, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.